Hello everyone and welcome to this video where I'm going to show you how to get the best ending in Assassin's Creed Valhalla. There will be no spoilers here, except I suppose for the choices that you need to make in order to get the ending, but not about the ending itself. So without further delay, here's how it works. It's basically very similar to The Witcher 3. In there you have 5 key choices with Ciri, and here we have 5 key choices with Sigurd. Even their names are kinda similar. But anyway, here are the choices. The first one is in the end of the intro section when you're about to leave Norway. So the question is brought up about whether you should take what you're owed before you leave. Your brother, Sigurd, prefers that you make a fresh start in England, and so the right choice here is to agree with him and leave empty-handed.
If you object, I understand. Let your father keep Kjotve's riches. England will have riches and cargo enough for us.
Good.
Next up, it's about love, specifically the Randvi romance. This one becomes available relatively soon after you arrive in England, and basically, you shouldn't do it. A new dialogue where you ask her how she is will appear at some point, which starts the romance quest, and you can either skip it entirely or reject her towards the end of the quest when things get serious. I suppose I'll give you a tiny spoiler for those who really want to romance her, and it is that you should just not do the quest. Because after the ending, there will be a point where you can romance her without any issues. But before the ending, just ignore that conversation. Okay, moving on to the third choice, which is about the confrontation between you, your brother, and Basim. At some point in the story, there will be an argument between the three of you, and when it gets really heated, you'll get an option to punch Sigurd. If you want the best ending, you should not punch him. In fact, right before that, you get an option to punch Basim as well. I'm honestly not sure if that affects the ending. I would say no, but just to be safe, don't punch Basim either. Just be nice. Now, the fourth choice is about Dag. As far as I can tell, he will always get mad with you, regardless of how hard you try not to upset him, and he will eventually challenge you to a fight to the death. When you defeat him, you get a chance to agree or refuse to send him to Valhalla. And as you may have guessed, the right choice here is to agree and let him die with his axe.
Take this and fly to Odin's hall. Whatever you sought in this life, may you find it in the next.
And finally, the fifth choice, which is once again about Sigurd, and more specifically, the second judgment scene. In there, regardless of what you choose, he will always show up and accuse the man. I forgot their names. Anyway, you can either agree or disagree with his verdict, and while it's quite harsh, the quote right choice is to agree with him.
Sigurd is our Jarl. His word is law, whether or not you agree.
So these are the five choices to get you the best ending, as far as I'm aware at least. Now, naturally, there's the question of, do we need 5 out of 5? And the answer is, I'm not sure. I've tried 5 out of 5, 0 out of 5, and 1 out of 5. The 0 and 1 resulted in the same bad ending, which by the way, you can check in the description if you're interested, you know, the good and bad endings. But anyway, I wonder what would happen if you get, say, 3 out of 5. In The Witcher 3, for example, that would still give you the good ending. Sadly, I'm not sure about this game, and if some of you knows more about this, please share it down in the comments. Now, I do have a speculation though. Based on how the dialogue during the ending is constructed, aka the fact that after Sigurd lists one of your mistakes, you will ask something along the lines of, is there anything else? And this only happens after the first thing he mentions. So I have the suspicion that if there isn't anything else, in other words, if you've only made one wrong choice, perhaps you'll still get the good ending? So it may be that 4 out of 5 is enough? So just to be safe, you should go for 5 out of 5. And yeah, I already mentioned that you can still romance Randvi after the ending. And I think this was it. I hope this video was helpful. Feel free to give it a like if it was. And if you have any more crucial information about the endings and how to get them, feel free to post it down in the comments. Okay, until the next video, stay tuned and be good.
By the way,
That spectacle with the coin. What was that?
Emperor's got lots. Couldn't see why he shouldn't share some with us.
Is that what this was about? From the start?
No. It's always been about you. Only you.
It sure seemed like it was about the coin in there.
Syria.
If it wasn't, you shouldn't have accepted it.
Say no more. I'll be over it by the time we reach Velen.